Sure. I am a singer, songwriter. My name is Taya Marquis. I sing R&B and pop music, mostly. And I also am an independent artist, so I take care of a lot of the business side of things too, so I'm pretty hands-on that way as an artist. And I like business. I like, I'm pretty enterprising, so yeah, I guess.
Okay.
I do a little bit of all three, being an artist, songwriting, and business.
Okay. How have you been handling the coronavirus situation with the lockdown and quarantine?
Oh, wow. Well, if I can be honest, I actually, this is going to sound weird, and I don't mean to be, like, rejoicing this moment.
Yeah.
But I am a positive person, so I try to always see the positive in things, and in my opinion, like, to be honest, I'm actually kind of liking it. I'm liking it because I'm able to be on CERB, like that whole government emergency funding thing. I was able to get that, and so that is, you know, coming in. And while I'm still being able to have, like, I finally had enough hours in the day to work on all of my music and all of my art and all of my goals and all of my dreams and all of my list of things to do. So it's not the craziest amount of money coming in, but it's something
to help.
Yeah, so it's kind of a weird, oddly cool situation, but obviously I'm hoping that they actually fix this quickly and we get out of it. I think this is the perfect time, actually, because everybody's, you know, forced to go on the internet now, be on the world wide web, and everyone's eyes are on their TikTok, IG live, like, you know, YouTube live, like there's so many, like Zoom, and all these new things that are popping up because we can only connect virtually now, so everyone's online, and it's the best time. Yes, you're going to be flooded with a lot of you know, competition and things like that, but it's important to, you know, take this opportunity to be out there and have your music out there so that people can connect with you, because they're looking on the internet anyway. So, you know, and also, like, for example, Shakespeare, he apparently wrote King Lear during a plague.
Oh.
Yeah, while during a plague back in the day. Same thing in quarantine. And it's like, okay, well, if Shakespeare wrote, you know, and he found creativity, that means, like, these times might evoke some sort of emotion out of us. And I think it's important to capitalize on that emotion and really, like, dig deep and create and use it to create. So, yeah.
Some of your music touches on topics of mental health?
Yes. Oh, yes. Yeah.
Do you feel that music can help people with this issue, and why?
Well, from two different perspectives, creating, I personally, it helps me in my mental health by creating music. Even just by singing on certain frequencies, it, like, helps my body, and it's very therapeutic to my body and my brain while I'm singing, you know, being a creator, it really is very, very therapeutic. Also getting my emotions into lyrics and, like, being able to put it in song and just get it out of my brain and just get it into a song is just very therapeutic. And so as a listener, listening to music, it has helped me so much in my mental health. Like, sometimes I don't even know why I'm sad and I don't even know what's going on with me sometimes, and I don't even know how to understand it. But when I go searching for the certain song, and I stumble on the song that just says everything that's in my brain perfectly without, you know, without me having to say it, and it's like, it's almost like the artist is going through what I'm going through at this very moment, and it's the weirdest thing. So as a listener, I think music really, really benefits people with mental health, because you can pick the right song and it could just change your whole mood, it could change your whole energy, it can change your whole vibe, because of the cadences in the song, because it's just a beautiful, you know, it's a beautiful chord progression, and it just makes you feel the energy of it. Or it could be what the singer's singing. Some country music, you know, really, really has done that for me too. So yeah, I think from a creative perspective, a creator and a listener, I think it helps mental health tremendously. Music is great that way.
Latest single, Strive, has a special message for music listeners. Could you describe what it is for us?
Strive is a very self-reflecting song, and it's basically I'm admitting to having these demons, and admitting to being a very, very scary person. Like, I'm admitting to being a very dangerous, scary person to love, to friend, to be with. But I'm also saying that I am going to strive to be better. I'm not going to let my demons win. And there is that sense of hope and faith that I also infuse in the song with, fighting my demons and not letting them win, not letting them get the best of me. Isn't that what we all strive for?
Yeah, that's...
that's literally my lyric.
That's a good message.
Isn't that what we all strive for? Yeah, exactly.
Yeah.
I mean, imagine if the whole world strived to be their best self. Like, every single person was striving and just trying to be their best self. Imagine how much better the world would be. You know?
It'd be crazy.
It would be a great world. At least a little bit better.
For sure.
Yeah.